A Channel 2 Action News investigation uncovered thousands of Georgians hurt on the job who reported having big problems accessing the medical care that they or their doctors wanted. Investigative reporter Aaron Diamond here with what the state admits is the source of these delays.
Look, when you get hurt, the only thing you're worried about is getting better. But we found many times Georgians who got hurt at work saw their recovery slowed by delays and denials for treatment by the folks footing the bill.
They pester you so much, it seems like, to where you get so aggravated where you finally just say, screw it.
Fed up over Georgia's profoundly complex workers' compensation system, more than 3 years after a horrific crash while on a company service call left Keith Grisco hurt so badly he nearly died twice.
I can't even describe the pain.
He's still recovering from disfiguring injuries, literally from head to toe, inside and out.
Our lawyers told us that, oh, they're going to be great at first, but, you know, wait a year or two, see what happens.
Grisco's initial emergency care got covered no problem, but he says his company's insurer wore him down with so many denials and delays authorizing follow-up care, prescriptions, and supplies, he finally caved in and accepted a settlement.
And you're just finally like, okay, fine, I'll settle for that. Jeez, I just want to wash my hands with y'all and be done.
Attorney Sarah Stottlemyre is adamant Grisco's not alone.
It's absurd. The way that the system is set up to frustrate people to where they finally give up.
A recent study by the nonprofit Workers' Compensation Research Institute found 18%, or nearly 1 in 5 Georgians injured at work, reported big problems getting services they or their primary provider wanted. Among those, 52%, more than half, gave employer or insurer did not want the care provided as the reason. From where State Workers' Comp Board Chairman Judge Frank McKay sits,
we see delays in getting the authorization where there's not an articulated reason for that delay. And that's the problem. I have recognized that, and we are targeting that.
New board rules, which take effect next year, will get judges involved sooner to sort out delays in a matter of days, plus the power to impose sanctions.
The payer proceeds at their peril in issuing delay after delay in a situation like that.
The board can already levy sanctions under its current rules, but when we asked McKay which companies it's punished for deliberate delays and how often, he told us the board doesn't track
sanctions. It just doesn't do that?
It does not. Not that I know of.
But that's something that maybe is worthwhile tracking.
I think all data is useful, and I think that would be useful as well.
McKay did say only 13% of all Georgia workers' comp claims opened each year end up before the board, but that's still more than 18,000 cases, including Sarah Stottlemyre's client, Lori Bunn.
For 4 years almost, my life's been on hold, and I don't know what's next.
A stool fell on Bunn's head in a stockroom nearly 4 years ago. When therapy didn't work, her doctor recommended neck surgery, but the insurer said no.
Sarah said, do you want to fight it? And I said, absolutely, let's fight this.
Bunn took her case to the board and lost, but won on appeal, a process that took another year. By then, the surgery she needed, far more serious.
I'd like to think that if it had been taken care of immediately, I wouldn't still be miserable 4 years later.
You're a human being. You're not a piece of machine. I'm in pain, and I'm going to be hurting for the rest of my life.
Well, the punchline here, prior approval for specific treatments or supplies is not required under Georgia law. However, many doctors in the workman's comp system demand some sort of payment guarantee up front. Meantime, while the board cannot control when and why workers choose to settle claims, it does review each settlement for red flags. And we should mention, we did try to speak with our state's employers advocate group about this issue, but had no luck.